It is 1:48 a.m. September 20, 2024. I have something to share with my followers. This lump, this 15 cm by 12 by 13 cm lump, for me is really a big blessing. I don't see it as anything negative. Of course, it is true, this lump, this sarcoma gave me so much pain for 3 days. Excruciating pain, 10 out of 10. Almost 72 hours without sleep because of this pain. So much pain, I even wanted to just sleep and go to heaven or purgatory, I don't know. But now I see the wisdom of this lump, because a year ago I was praying intently to God to show me my purpose. What could be my purpose? I lost 2 elections. The 2022 was a lopsided election. People don't like you. People don't need you. People even blame you. Even my views were so low, or maybe 5 to 10,000 views in YouTube. You can check it. It looks like I lost my 17 million Facebook and 9 million YouTube followers. They are there, but they are not watching me anymore. I said to the Lord, it is okay for me to retire anytime. But still I felt, Lord, there is so much problems in the Philippines, never heard before. The issue between the president and the vice president, the two camps, is escalating every day. The magnitude of hate, maybe even violence, unforgiveness, lack of compassion is evident. They are being thrown on one side, on two sides. Who is right? Who is wrong? Perhaps both are a little right, and perhaps both are a little wrong. Somebody should start to forgive. Then we have the world conflict with US and Russia and Israel and Palestine and Taiwan and China and Japan, Philippines, North Korea. So much tension in the world. Some say we are on the brink of economic collapse, a great recession. I told God, it's up to you to use me. But I feel at 60, I have some more work to do. A week or so ago, I saw my mother, who was dead for 2 years. She was young, 55, so pretty, so loving. No, maybe around 45, I was just a little boy, 3 years old in a crib. And she was there, she was trying to get me by the armpits and lift me. And bring me to that beautiful face, beautiful place in heaven, probably. But I was confused. Although I love her, there seems to be some people tugging at my leg. My sister and nephew and niece were fervently praying to keep me on earth. So I look at them, I saw my 2 daughters who still need me alive. And my wife too. And of course, more importantly, I see a vision of me trying to bring peace in the Philippines, trying to give the president his freedom of choice. Everyone has a choice. The president has a choice to do it the left way, the right way, the middle way. And his choice, the president's choice, will affect millions and millions of lives, not only in the Southeast Asian region, but the world. So I pray for wisdom for President BBM. So I am there trying to bring peace. I thank the Vice President VP Sara for such a heartfelt letter. I thank Amy Marcos, who called. We chatted a long time. Bam Aquino, Bongo servicio mang bisyo. And yesterday I talked with DND Secretary Gibo Teodoro, my classmate, for 12 years, grade school to high school, wishing me well. And I had a very, very nice conversation with Secretary Benher Abalos, which I would like to share one day. No politics, no nothing. He was just so worried looking at me and my bald head. Because we met, I think, around 3 years ago when he was in MMDA. My message, my tips are: one, you are lucky if you can still plan 1 year ahead. You can plan your vacation in the next 6 months. You can plan your children's party next year. But look at me. I can only plan until tomorrow. At most, I will plan until 1 or so weeks. Because I do not know if I will still be alive next week. This thing in my stomach is so huge. Any sudden movement will give it pain. Or it might break one of the blood vessels it is attached to. It is even, I feel, blocking my small intestine. So be happy if you can plan. Number two, try to forgive your enemies. If you are in my situation, enemies do not matter anymore. I called 3 or 4 people. Who we can say is probably I had some friction with, but now it is all done. I mended family ties, friendship ties, and that made me so happy. And number three, I fulfilled my mission to help, to inspire as much as I can. Finally, I thank you all for your prayers and love. But remember, I am the lucky one. I get the best care in Singapore. I have relatives to support me, who pitch in for my medical expense. All my brothers, my nephews, my nieces are pitching in. So I am so lucky. And I do not want to be the only one lucky getting the best care here. I want our beloved Philippines and poor people to enjoy such health care. If God gives me time. Only if God wills it. So when you pray, pray for your neighbor who has no food to eat. Pray for the beggars who would love cold water. Help the old lady cross the street. Say a nice word to a friend. Make them smile. Those little things will give you good karma. And if you still have a little energy, say a little prayer for me. And I will return that prayer 100-fold. You cannot go wrong with service. You cannot go wrong with love. Find your mission. Love one another as Jesus has loved us. I love you all for the Filipino people, but I really feel a strong urge to help the world and prevent nuclear war. As I slowly see and understand the dynamics. Lastly, I say, pray the rosary every day. Pray to the Blessed Virgin Mary, especially Our Lady of Lourdes. Second, to pray to Padre Pio with his stigmata and miracles. And third, to pray to the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for this earth, for this life, for these problems and sickness, because it will help us align ourselves into your image, your love. I thank everyone.